Yeah, that question drives to the heart of the problem. The fact that, as physicians, we are limited in our ability to identify people at real present risk. We can say to someone, in the next 10 years, you are really at high risk of having a heart attack. But what does that mean for a specific patient? They say, do I have a plaque? Do I have a plaque that's about to break? And our answer is, well, I don't know, I didn't look, but looking at your blood, look, it's almost like saying, if I look there and there and there, I can kind of guess what happens there. You don't do that with colon cancer, right? You don't look at the stools to make an intervention. You have to look inside the colon. So I think it is about time, it's overdue for us to include imaging, like looking at the right spot, so that we can add to the biomarkers, the cholesterol, the blood pressure, the sugar, the uric acid, the family history, the lifestyle, and all these things. They amount to something, but really the difference is look and see. Of course, in a young person, you look and see nothing most of the time, so it's very difficult to make prediction in a young person, but guess what? Young people don't have an epidemic of heart attacks. It's a very sporadic event. So if we just were looking at the absolutely unpredictable cases, it wouldn't be a big societal problem. The societal problem is that it happens to people who are of a certain category, like older, with comorbidities, with risk exposures, with genetic predispositions. We know these people, but we don't know exactly who among these people of high risk has the seeds, the plaque, the problem already, and we need to just go see it. So I think you are right. For as long as we adopt a passive stance where we say the first thing has to be you complaining, you saying you don't feel that well, then we have missed out up to 50%. We need to have a system that identifies what we call preclinical atherosclerosis.